YouTube, how y'all like that intro song, y'all? That new intro looking tough, right? I'm gonna see how to place it, see whatever, figuring it out. Hopefully the person that made that song doesn't copyright me. I mean, I don't know if you can get copyrighted for 10 seconds of a song, but yeah, I know you can get content ID'd no matter what. So I'm gonna probably put it in a couple of my videos just in case, you know what I'm saying, I get banged over the top of the head. But yeah, today we're gonna be going over how to do the full prelude glitch. This is in-depth guide. This is the one that's working after the patch. It's the same one from yesterday, but it's just I'm explaining it again, and I'm explaining all like the full method. So basically, what you want to do, you want to first create a profile. After you create your profile, you want to go into the prelude. You want to play your ass off in the first game so you can try to get halfway to a badge or a badge. If you That's the best way to do it, because you're going to want to go into the next game with quick draw on bronze, right? Or at least play, you know what I'm saying, to the best of your ability. Now, a lot of y'all was asking me, how do I get up to the point? You play that first game, then you travel to Los Angeles. You play this game versus Kawhi, and all you do is just run away, give him the ball, and let him score. It's the easiest way to do it. After this, then the Portsmouth Invitational game is gonna be there, right? Once you get to the Portsmouth Invitational game, pretty much you're gonna play the whole game full. I'm gonna tell you what jump shots to equip. That's gonna basically make it so the game is really easier, and we're behind the back to equip. This is for all guard builds and stuff like that. I don't know, for centers, you really just play. But for guards, you can either upgrade your 3 to a 70. That will help a lot, and only cost 2,000 VC. Small little investment, right? And you for jump shots, you want to use jump shot 38. Now, the reason why you want to use jump shot 38 is because it's the fastest jump shot, right, in the game naturally. The fastest natural jump shot. So that means its base is the fastest, it's the quickest. So gold, so quick draw on bronze and silver is, you know what I'm saying, it's gonna make it really fast. You don't need to put it on quick draw on Hall of Fame. You can literally have quick draw on silver, like I have on my main player, and use jump shot 38, and you're gonna do fine. Behind the back pro 3 and dribble pull up normal 4. If you're 70 overall, you can use Stephen Curry, but normal 4 is all you'll need. Now, also, I forgot to mention, VC winners will be announced for the giveaway at the end of the video, so stay tuned for that. Please don't skip, but yeah, I mean, you can skip if you want, but yeah, to see if it's you and then come back. But yeah, basically what you wanted to get, do in this game, is you literally just you run down, and you just snatch back. How do you snatch back? You flick down on the right stick when you're running towards a defender, and then just green the three in their face. You know what I'm saying? Make sure you focus on your shot, because you can hit a lot of shots in this game with a 63. If you put it to 70, then you're gonna really be hitting, and you're gonna really be scoring like 60 and 70. I think I end up scoring like 48 here with just a 63. You know what I'm saying? And no badges. As you accumulate more badges, it's gonna get easier. How do you accumulate more badges? Now, somebody asked me yesterday, how do you accumulate more badges and then you still use it on your player? Basically, what you're gonna want to do is you're gonna want to load into your game, and right when you're in the lobby, you join a friend and you join their game into the park. You join their neighborhood, right? You join their game, you click on their gamer tag, and you join game. And that's gonna make it so you can join them into the neighborhood, and you can add your badges, you can add VC to your guy, you can switch around your jump shots. You can even get jump shot boosts. Like, if you really want to speed up this process, you can get jump shot boosts and make it super OP. But as you can see, like, I'm greening with Gatorade, as you can see, and I'm making this even better. So that's what I do recommend. If you really want to speed up this process, jump shot boosts. You load into your friend's neighborhood, you get jump shot boosts, boost your 3 to like a 70, and it'll make this process way faster. This is easy for shooters. Now, if you guys, this is easy for shooters and defenders. Like, finishing is always going to be easy, but it's always going to take time regardless. Something like playmaking is probably the hardest thing to do on here, because passing to these bums for them to get assist is not the easiest thing to do. Shooting is the easiest, then it's finishing. Finishing is probably the easiest, because all you have to do is rim run. But as you can see, at the end of the game, I slow it down here. You can see at the end of the game, I get almost 16,000 XP in attribute points, and I get almost 14,000 in shooting, right? And this is not me drifting. If you had a higher 3, you could drift. Once you get difficult shots, you can drift. You see standing 3s? I get almost 7,000 in standing 3s, right? And they gave me a little bonus. I don't know why, but they gave me bonus. That's what I'm saying. In this game mode, they're gonna give you bonus. Because I only got 7,000 points, but I got 14,000 for shooting. It's like doubled for some reason. If you guys saw that, right? So right after that, you want to just quit the game right there. And after you see the VC load, and after you see it's telling you your projections. Now what that's going to do is that's going to load you back in. Once you go here, you're going to get loaded back into the game. Now you can either go play it again if you want and don't equip any badges and just play it again. You don't stack VC, they patched that. The VC is no longer stacking, but you can either play it again or you can go to the park and join in somebody's neighborhood, join a friend's neighborhood. Once you get to the lobby, if you got an error code, just wait until you're in the lobby first. When you're right here at this screen, you can either join back in or join a friend's neighborhood. Go find a friend that's in the neighborhood, join their game, and just load back in. Once you load back in, you can equip your badges now. Now, this is where the easy part comes in. Because once you're here, basically you upgrade your stats, you can upgrade your badges. I say upgrade your shot to a 70, because once you're a 73, you can shoot lights out. 73, 70 mid, if you're, you know what I'm saying, if you're like a shot creator or a mid-range specialist on one of those builds, 70 is the perfect, you know what I'm saying, it's not too much of an investment just in case you want to switch your build, and you can switch it at any time. So first badge I would recommend get into is quick draw on silver, and then working on difficult shots, because fades are going to give you more XP than standing shots, and that's what I recommend you doing. And then if you're a slasher, I couldn't tell you, maybe contact finisher. It's pretty easy to slash in this game. So if you do also want, you can put your ball handling up so you can practice dribbling and get used to dribbling. That's what I'm going to do. I'm going to go live after this video. We're going to make this build live on stream. And then, so that's pretty much what I'm going to do. So you'll just quit and then you'll just go back into the game. You can just load back into the game and you can literally just redo the process. Now it's super easy. This is a super easy process. This is why I actually, you know what I'm saying? This is why I like this, because now it's not the easiest, right? It's not like the other glitch where you're literally just on autopilot. You actually do have to play. But if you're doing one shooting badge a game, that's 30 games. You know what I'm saying? I'm not going to do the math for that, but that's 10 minutes. You know what I'm saying? That's probably like 5 hours. Off the top of my head, I think that's 5 hours. What is that? 6 badges an hour? That's 60 minutes. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, I think that's 5 hours, right? I know somebody cut my ass on the math last time, but you know what I'm saying? I'm not the greatest at math. But yeah, you just redo the process, and that's pretty much how it is for the glitch. Now, thank you guys for watching the video, and I'm out. Peace. Now for the giveaway winners, you guys can see I actually did this live. I recorded myself. I didn't know how to zoom in because I'm so bad at editing now. I used to be good at editing back when I played RuneScape, but I didn't know how to zoom in, so I just did the giveaway live. Just did the re-roll on this random YouTube comment picker website, and yeah, this is who the first winner was. First winner was hashtag TV, and as you can see, it even says for me to re-roll it, but I'm not going to do it. And then he said re-roll it, but matter of fact, wait, my son plays 2K, so hashtag TV, hit me up on Twitter. And then, you know what I'm saying, Xbox or PS4 is going to be a $10 code. I did another re-roll because I said two winners will be given out, so I was going to do another code for another $10 code, and the winner was, you guys can see right here, was Mr. iWelch. Or IL Watch. So just hit me up on Twitter and give me your console, and I'll give you a $10 PSN code or Xbox code of your choice, you know what I'm saying? Or $10 Cash App of your choice, or PayPal, whatever payment method you want. So that's it. Thank you guys for watching the video, and I'm out. Peace.